friends, today we are going to study the electrolytic refining of copper. This diagram shows a cell in which we are going to carry out the process of electrolysis. You can see two rods here. One rod is thick and one rod is comparatively thinner. So since we are carrying out the refining of copper, the thick rod, this is of impure copper. This is impure copper rod and this is the anode or the positive electrode. Now, how do we come to know which electrode is to be taken as positive? The electrode which is connected to the positive terminal of the battery is marked as positive and the electrode which is connected to the negative terminal of the battery is marked as cathode or the negative electrode. So the impure copper rod acts as the anode and this is a thin strip of pure copper. Which acts as the cathode. The solution that we have taken in this cell is of copper sulfate. This is copper sulfate solution. In bracket, we will be mentioning aqueous because it is a solution of copper sulfate in water. This is a battery through which the current will flow through the circuit. Now, once the current is switched on, what happens is that the anode, it starts dissolving. So at anode, the copper that is present in this rod starts dissociating into copper ions and producing free electrons. Now in this process, since electrons are being given out, this is the oxidation process that is going on. This is oxidation. Loss of electrons means oxidation. Now, the copper ions that are being produced here go in solution. The electrons that are being produced, they flow through the external circuit and come towards the cathode. Now, since more and more of negative charge is being collected at the cathode, the copper ions positive charge which is being accumulated in the solution, it starts getting neutralized. So, at cathode or the negative electrode, the copper ions from the solution, they start gaining electrons coming through the circuit and they get converted back to copper metal and starts getting deposited on this strip. So after some time, this rod will become thinner. Finally, it may finish also and while this rod will become thicker and the pure copper is being deposited at the cathode. The impurities that are present in this rod, they will either fall down over here, the insoluble impurities, they will fall down over here. We call it the anode mud because they are coming out of the anode. And the soluble impurities, they go in solution and they get dissolved in this solution. So this is how the electrolysis of copper or the electrolytic refining of copper is carried out. The copper that is obtained from this method is about 99.9% pure. This method can be used for the refining of other metals also. The thing that has to be taken care of is that the anode should always be of the metal which has to be purified. For example, if we have to carry out the refining of silver, this anode has to be of impure silver, this cathode has to be of pure silver. And the solution that we are taking should be of some sort of silver. We can say a solution of silver nitrate can be taken for the purpose. Similarly for other metals. I hope the concept is clear. Thank you and keep watching.